Heats of formation are often used to calculate a heat of reaction. The heat of reaction is calculated by summing up the heats of formation of the products multiplied by their stoichiometric coefficients minus the sum of the heats of formation of the reactants also multiplied by their stoichiometric coefficient. So let's take a look at an example of how we can use these calculations to find an unknown heat of formation. In this particular problem, we're actually given the heat of reaction and we're given the heat of formation for the CO2 and the heat of formation of H2O, which is in its liquid form. With this information, what we want to know is what is the heat of formation of liquid C6H6. We'll write this out in terms of what we know. So our heat of reaction is going to equal, now let's take a look at the stoichiometric coefficients. Coming out, we have 12 times the heat of formation of the CO2 plus 6 times, and these are the stoichiometric coefficients, the heat of formation of the H2O liquid. We subtract from that the heats of formation coming in. The heats of formation of any substance in its most stable or elemental form is 0. So we do not have to, as we look back at this, include this oxygen in our calculation. So this is -2, because that's the stoichiometric coefficient of the C6H6, times the heat of formation of our C6H6, and this has to equal the heat of reaction. So we can simplify this, and note that we are now in kilojoules instead of kilojoules per mole because we multiplied those heats of formation by moles. So now all we have to do is solve for this heat of formation, which is equal to a positive 48.6 kilojoules per mole.